Hey, Donald.
Oh, I'm sorry, okay, no. The landscape of MLK's on there too, I'm sorry.
Right, staff of both. Staff, I'd like to approve staff recommendation.
Okay, there a second?
I'll second the motion.
All right, call the roll.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Commissioner Street?
Yes.
Chairman Brunicki?
Yes.
Chairman Brunicki, I draw your attention to item number three, which is residential and commercial improvement grants update. In your packet, there was an agenda item that talked about the CRA commercial and residential grants that have been awarded this year. As backup, a deadline of June 1st, 2021 was set for the receipt of CRA grant applications throughout the four CRAs. In summary, a total of 30 grants were awarded to residents and business owners within the four CRA districts. The total dollar amount awarded was $540,000. In comparison to fiscal year 1920, this is a 67% increase in the number of grants awarded. As you can see from the four CRAs, there were a number of items that were budgeted, and then you see the current balances. And as backup, we have provided you with documentation of where all of those projects currently exist. Many of them are completed, some are still in process. I won't bore you with the other information. I'm sure at some time you have the opportunity to review all of those documents.
Would you say all that again, please? Oh, just kidding.
Questions about any of the scope of work or status or anything?
Yeah,
a lot getting done.
It's cool. There's a lot. That's great.
Absolutely.
Mr. Johnson, what happens with these projects that are undone when we move into the next fiscal year? Does that money carry over? How does exactly that work?
Yes, sir. That will carry over to allow the applicant an opportunity to complete the project.
Okay.
Right. Item number four talks about the district's updates. And so the very first one is Downtown North, and I'd like to have Ms. Champlain come up and explain what's going on in her ward. But before she comes up, or as she comes up, I want the board to have an opportunity to recognize Ms. Champagne's birthday, which is today.
Oh, happy birthday, Tony.
Happy birthday.
You know, it's my daughter Lauren's birthday, too. Now, she's 41 today, and what are you, 42?
Yeah. Probably 39.
There you go. That's it.
All right. Well, thank you. You have within your packet information on the updates for the district. You'll note information for Downtown North and our efforts in the last month or so has really been our welcome baskets. And as you noticed from the media, it was well received and people were really excited. So as backup to that action, I have included for you the listing of the new businesses. And our source here is the business listings, mm-hmm. where people apply for business licensing, sure. with the city. So it becomes like a mailing list function is how we've used it.
Yes.
Okay.
Jerry's Burger's making me hungry right now.
I'm sorry?
Looking at Jerry's Burger, I'm getting hungry right now.
Yes. Any questions regarding Downtown North? Now, also one of the important things to note with Downtown North is that we're the committees, we're in the process of planning a farmer's market. Mm-hmm. And the farmer's market is to commence the second Sunday of the month. This was the decision of the group. And young lady in our audience, Michelle, has worked very diligent with the committee, with the community. We're in the process now of seeking vendors. Yep. It will be located at A.D. Harris Learning Village in the large parking lot, you know, the one that has the gate.
Good location.
Yes, it yes. Really and what we're replacing or trying to mediate a food desert. That's one of the things that's happening throughout the CRA, because Millville suffers from the same thing, is a yeah. food desert. And you know that we've started a food farmer's market in Millville. So we will initiate one in Glenwood, and the time is 11 to 3. The members, committee members thought that it would be really nice. And this is some of my draft for signage. Because we're not on the main strip, so we're going to have to lead people to us. You'll notice some of the arrows.
So you're gonna be in the parking lot in front of the gym or the other end?
Front of the gym.
Front of the gym, good.
Right, we're gonna take like we do with the barbecue cook-off and red velvet cake contest. Okay, any other feedback, comments for the Downtown North? Moving on to the Millville. I provided you with a summary of some of our activities. Would really like to, even though she's not here, but for the record, to thank Commissioner Halagus. She is really involved with the committee. Committee members are really, they have that closeness, that contact, and that is really great. Sean DePalma has attended on occasion, and that is really great because, the members can interact with staff. They have firsthand information about the parks, and that's great. So Millville, again, we have a farmer's market, and that's where we're really trying to lift, and it's a group process kind of effort because we're allowing people to come together and build a team. What you have also, we did our initial, and you have this in your packet, our yard of the month. And it was really exciting. Nice home right on 3rd Street and well manicured. It was a great implementation of fencing because that's something that we've really highlighted in the CRAs is the removal, if possible, of chain link fencing. And you know, that's one of the eligible activities for our grants, as well as working with businesses and homeowners in the removal of chain link fencing. So we're really proud to celebrate our first yard of the month. Now the way it works, the recipient of the yard of the month then becomes the selector, and they will then decide on the next yard of the month, and then we'll end up with probably 12 people. And at the end of the year, we'll have a yard of the year. And the concept is to get folks to really invest in the outer appearance. Because, you know, my mom used to say, far more people drive by than come in. So that means keep your yard clean.
That's okay. Right.
Any questions about Downtown North of Millville? Thank you so much.
I don't have any, but I think we had an audience person that would like to ask a question. If we're doing that at this point or not, I don't know. But
Tony.
Mr. Johnson,
Tony.
Whoever.
Mayor. Yes, I would like that.
You got that.
I figured. Reference the farmer's market that's going to be held at A.D. Harris. I was wondering, do you have a list of the vendors that's to participate on the one that's held on Saturdays downtown across from the McKenzie Park? Do you have a list of the vendors that participate with the one in St. Andrews? And furthermore, do you have a list of the vendors that participate with the one in Millville? And being that it's on a Sunday, I think that's a pretty good idea, so we won't conflict with any of the other farmer markets that are participating. And I would like to hear what vendors have already contacted you and what type of vegetables and things of that nature will be at this farmer's market.
Thank you, Mr. Bell. I do not have the list on me as you present that question. I can get back with you with that information. The downtown market that happens on Saturday mornings is led by a Mr. Davenport. Davenport and I work together on the Millville's market. I can provide you with the vendors for the Millville market. Additionally, there is a market in Callaway that occurs on the second Sunday. So we were trying, as we look for days, we were trying not to be in conflict, but we thought that with Callaway, Millville, that, you know, Panama City is growing and diverse enough that it should be able to handle different markets. So we wanted to go forward with that. St. Andrews information, I can follow up and get that information to you as well. So, but I'm not prepared to respond with the list of vendors today. No problem.
Thank you. Now we'll have Ms. Lena Webb to talk about downtown and what's going on there.
Morning.
Morning.
With our downtown district, we are still building on our committees. That's kind of been our main focus, is try to get our committees together for our Main Street committees. We do have a core group that we've met one time, only had a couple members that were able to attend, and then this month's meeting had some other issues that came in, but I think I've met with each one of them to go over what we've been talking about. A couple of things we've been talking about, going off of the Yard of the Month, we wanted to build a Business of the Month for downtown. So we're working on a plan for that to recognize our businesses downtown and, you know, the upkeep of their buildings as we're revitalizing the downtown area. And then, of course, in with that, we were part of the Welcome Baskets, and that was a huge success. We've had a lot of response back from people, and then working with a lot of our people downtown with grants. We've had a number of them downtown, so we're growing quickly. We're seeing a lot of people interested in the downtown area, and we're looking forward to the future. Is there any other questions? Or
I didn't know we were... That grants included security cameras.
Mm-hmm.
That's pretty good.
Yes, yeah. It's something that is actually becoming a little more popular these days.
Well, I know they're very popular. I didn't know that grants included that, though.
Right, and when you have the walkability that you want in town, those security cameras are, it's a great asset to the building.
It's a necessity.
Mm-hmm.
Business especially.
We also found through our grant program, the bead gallery right there at the beginning,
right there,
you know, close to the corner of 6th,
yes.
We revealed an old RC Cola mural on one of the walls. So that was revealed through the renovations, working on trying to find somebody to preserve that,
that
mural, because that, of course, had a lot of media attention. And overwhelmingly, everyone wants us to restore that, that sign,
yeah.
And both owners of the buildings that share that wall are absolutely for preserving that. So working on trying to find somebody for that.
I bet you remember that, Greg. That RC Cola mural.
Knee high and RC Cola and New Grape and Colbert wine. I remember it all. St. Andrew.
Tony, did you have a question before or another statement before we move on to St. Andrew's?
Question or statement, but I did would like to introduce, if I have not, Michelle Clay. Michelle works really closely with Main Street / CRA, and she's the chair of the Economic Vitality, the new committees of Main Street, and she's also have given her lead for the farmers market. And on this side of the aisle, I have Dick Lovejoy, who's the chair for the organization committee. And Mr. Lovejoy has been with me for years and years and years and years. So organizationally, we work together on the budget. We also have Ed Bell, who's participated in the Millville meeting, because we have different committees doing different types of work. So I just wanted to showcase some of the structure and the people that work with the committee in the community.
Thank you for your time, Michelle. Eddie.
Hey, everybody.
Dick, thank you. Appreciate your efforts.
So being chief cook and bottle washer, I've supplied a number of updates that share throughout all of the four CRAs. The very first item that's not in the packet that you received, Mr. Street, I just wanted you to be advised that we did receive a phone call yesterday, and the trash receptacles and benches have been shipped, and so hopefully they will be here this week.
Praise.
Nice.
The other item that is not in your packet, we have gone through a vetting process, and we have selected a CRA manager. So at our next meeting, we will probably have an opportunity to introduce that individual to you. As far as St. Andrews is concerned, on Monday, June 14th, which was last week, staff, along with our logistics team and other members of the Waterfront Partnership, had an opportunity to tour the St. Andrew School. While the school is historic and built well over 70 years ago, from the interior standpoint, it withstood well against the effects of Hurricane Michael. The site visit also showed a great number of possibilities for the facility to be a community center and tourist attraction. So we're really looking forward to the progress on rehabbing that building and making it a very nice attribute to the St. Andrews community. The other item that was in your packet had to do with the banner program. So at the April 27th meeting, we discussed how the program continues to grow, especially with our ability to recognize a number of our stakeholders and citizens for their dedication and service to our community. Right now, we're having some issues with DOT as far as displaying those banners on the utility poles because it's against their policy. So Johnny Sims is a point of contact person with DOT, and hopefully we could work that out. If not, what we will have to do is purchase some pole banners that are very similar to the ones that are in St. Andrews, as well as on Jinx Avenue and then on Harrison. So look forward to possibly coming back to the board to seek their approval on that item. One of the other things that we're doing within the community, and I showed you a flyer, it's called Gaining Appreciation by Adjusting Perspectives. So you know what's going on throughout the nation. There's been a lot of mass shootings. There's been a lot of youth that have been shot and so on and so forth. So what we're doing is we're having a meeting on July 21st, and so we're allowing youth of our city to have dialogue with law enforcement. So not too long ago, there was an incident where one of the youth was about to be pulled over, and instead of pulling over in a well-lighted area, he decided to drive all the way home. So that gave the law enforcement the idea that he was trying to elude. And what we'd like to do is to be able to tell youth exactly what it is that you should do if you encounter law enforcement. And we'd also like the youth to have an opportunity to share with law enforcement, you know, what kind of fears they have. In addition, if our youth have an opportunity to see a crime being committed, would they call law enforcement? And so we want to have that dialogue between law enforcement and youth. And so far, we have the Panama City Police Department involved, as well as Lynn Haven, Springfield, Florida Highway Patrol, and then we're getting the Sheriff's Office involved as well. So that meeting, that focus group, will be held on July 21st at the Glenwood Community Center.
Michael, I have a question.
Yes, sir.
Maybe it's just a generation thing with me, but when I was in driver's ed, we were taught those things. Are they not being taught today, these young people?
Well, because a lot of the schools aren't teaching driver's ed now.
Okay.
So there's no opportunity to share that information, so.
Okay.
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 Commissioner Brown, you were going to say something?
No.
Oh, okay.
I did have a question.
Just listening.
Mr. Johnson, on the St. Andrews School, I know we had discussed at one of the waterfront partnerships of potentially there being some conflicts with doing classes and things like there. Have we broached that conversation? I mean, I don't know if we engaged even with Mr. Zimmerman over here.
I don't think we can operate it as a school. But
Michael brought to our attention that there were some restrictions inside of the deeds that prevented us from doing like adult classes, like or doing a cooking class, like those kind of things. And so I know that was some of the community feedback was eventually, and granted, this is a long way away, but everything legal takes a really long time.
I think it's a matter of semantics, and I was using the word enrichment, which would probably allow that to go on. Nevin, if
I like
you want to weigh
enrichment.
In, I know there was, it was specifically stated in the agreement that we couldn't have any educational classes. Is that not correct?
Yeah. In a few months, I'll let you know.
Okay.
It's a school.
Yeah, okay.
Just a school.
Okay. Yeah, that's yeah. Good. The other item that the CRA got involved with was the Bay Employee Bay Youth Program. So a lot of our employers here in Panama City, especially during the pandemic, had a problem or a challenge with employing anyone. And so what we did was we implemented a program to find youth who were interested in becoming employed for the next 2 months while they're out of school. We reached out to all of the students within Bay District Schools. We received about 100 kids that were very interested. We also made contact with a number of the businesses within Panama City as well as Bay County. Cracker Barrel alone requested 15 to 20 kids, which we thought was great. And then many of the other fast food restaurants, even some of the law agencies or offices asked for individuals to work during the summer, especially to give them some experience and some training, and this will certainly help on their college education, college applications, as well as put a little money in their pocket. It will especially keep them out of trouble. And so that's another thing that we wanted to accomplish. So we found this to be a very successful program, and we hope to expand it again next year. As far as the Jinx Avenue landscape design at the post office, that work has begun. Soon you should see some major changes at that particular post office. There'll be some ground covering, such as new sod in place, as well as some decorative foliage and so on. There'll be a one-year maintenance agreement with the contractor that's doing the work, so thereafter the city will, of course, or the CRA will have to pick up after that. Lastly, we are in the process of creating a public-private partnership, RFP, which we hope to announce soon, particularly the parcel that's located on Beck Avenue, which is a city-owned parcel. We also own several larger city-owned parcels, one on Northeast Avenue, as well as the Washington Carver Roosevelt property, as well as the property located across from Life Management. So we hope to get some responders who will bring some economic opportunities to the city, as well as future affordable workforce housing.
If that, if the rest of the parcels are not ready, do you think, Michael, we've got the potential to just go out with Beck in July?
Yes, that's going to be the starting one. We're going to have to do four separate RFPs.
All right. Okay.
And Beck Avenue is the main one that we're starting with. And we just had a conversations with our consultants yesterday to review and try to revise the RFP. So we're getting to a place where once it's completed, it will then go to legal for their blessing. And after that, we should be able to announce the RFP or advertise
it. Great. Looking forward to that.
Okay. I'm available for any questions if anyone has any.
All right. Public comment?
And Mr. Chairman and board members, Rufus Wood, 1911 East 10th Street. I just really had some questions. I wanted to find out what is the status of the expansion of the downtown north. I understand it's supposed to be expanded to Redwood Avenue. I know some of the citizens were requesting that it would go beyond that, but I wanted to know what is the status of that. I wanted to find out Oscar Patterson is, if I understand it's going to be expanded to Redwood, so that would include Oscar Patterson. And we all know Oscar Patterson is a historic institution, education institution in Panama City. It's actually started as Millville Elementary School in 1920, I understand. So it is a historic institution. And back during the 60s, it was one of the leading institutions in the Panhandle. So with the CRA funds, if it's going to be expanded to Redwood Avenue, that would include Oscar Patterson. And we would certainly like to see some investment in Oscar Patterson. Of course, that would include Rosenwald too. But we're particularly at this time concerned about Oscar Patterson because the superintendent and the school board, they've already voted to reopen the school beginning in 2023 school year. So I wanted to find out what investment can be made there if we're going to do the expansion. And then my last question was in relations to the African American Cultural Center. When we met with Mr. McQueen, he assured us that at A.D. Harris that it would be reopened because there were people coming home for the summer who wanted to see the artifacts. And he assured us that it would be reopened. So I haven't heard anything on that. So if Mr. Johnson can help me on those questions, I would appreciate that.
Yes, sir, Dr. Woods. As far as the expansion is concerned, we're working with our consultant, SNME. They're in the process of completing the finding of necessity for expanding. It was a 6-month process. And so we are still working towards that. Not long after that, we are going to set up meetings where the public can give their input as far as the expansion is concerned, and so everyone will be notified once we're at that point. As far as the cultural center is concerned, there were some issues with the flooring. The flooring has been completed as of yesterday, and so within the next 15 to 20 days, we will start moving the artifacts back into A.D. Harris.
Okay, thank you. So in terms of the expansion, are you saying we haven't voted on the line? I mean, is Redwood Avenue going to be the line?
Yes, sir, it is.
Okay. All right, so that would include Oscar Patterson, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so are you considering investing in Oscar Patterson? Because Oscar Patterson needs some help. As I just stated, it's been here for a while. That building, I think, was built in 59, if my research was correct. So those buildings are old, and we need some investment in the school. So that's what I'm here for. I've been fighting for Oscar Patterson for more than a decade, and I want us to consider that. So would you be considering that?
Yes, sir. Well, we'd have to talk to the school board about that. But yes, sir, we will take that into consideration.
Thank you very much.
Just an eye. You want to change the clock? Walter P. Henry, 614 Maple Avenue. I was saying it'll be go to Redwood. Will it be going towards 7th Street?
Yeah, yes.
Will it go from 11th Street to 7th or what?
Yes, it would be inclusive, yes.
That's so I want to know that. I want to know, where are we coming with our houses? Are we getting any imitations? We got any buyers?
I know
we
got
them. Do we have any imitations for the houses that the city is building right now? Because I know we have the houses, but I don't see it. Don't look like nobody's is interested or something. Do we have any people interested in the houses?
So we have two contracts that are. Burke and Blue is currently working on the houses on Horizon Park. Is that what you're referring to?
Yes, those and the two that we got on, you have on 15th Street and Roosevelt, I believe.
And there's two contracts on those as well, out of the three. So there are only three on Roosevelt and 15th. There's two contracts, and then out of the six houses that are on Horizon Park, there's two contracts on those as well.
All right. Are they sold or some? Have they been sold?
Well, yeah, if we've got a contract to purchase.
They're not closed yet.
They're not closed yet. They haven't gone to closing, but we have a contract to purchase.
All right. I just figured the one on Roosevelt, I know they've been sitting there a while. They're not finished yet? I know you got one at 15, you got one on around the corner.
Right. So what caused the delay for the third house on Roosevelt was the fact that DOT is widening 15th Street. So initially the plan was to have all three houses right there in a row, starting with the corner. When we found out that DOT was widening and the road was going to come right through the middle of the foundation of that house, we had to move it further down. So the completion of that house just occurred probably a week ago, and so we have to do a walkthrough, develop a punch list to make sure there are no outstanding items. So the first two houses that front Roosevelt are completed and have contracts on them. The third house we're waiting.
All right, the one that we visit that you were showing us, are those houses completed? Are they just, I know some of them look like they're, to me it look like they're already finished. I just wondered if we got any buyers, anybody interested?
Okay, the houses that we looked at were the first two that were constructed. Those two have contracts on them. Houses 4, 5, and 6 are still in the completion stage. Right. So there are no contracts on them yet.
All right. I just want to know, because sometimes folks ask you, and I just want to know that, telling me that we got somebody who just ain't got the everything set for the houses to be sold yet. I just want to, when I tell somebody something, or they ask me something, I want to make sure that I'm telling them the right thing.
I understand.
All right.
Is there a closing date on any of those under contract?
I don't have that information with me. I have to get back with you.
Okay.
I won't be 3 minutes. I just want to be your eyes and ears, give you some things to think about when you start preparing your agenda. Just like the Oakland Terrace Park that's on 11th Street, it looks fabulous. Ride by there, see people participating there. We'd love to see Daphne Park look just like that. Another thing over at Oakland Terrace, on some different boards that I'm participating on, you know, our ex-superintendent, Stephanie Gall, that theater over there is named after her. Please put that into your works. That group that you honored here, they came to the Kiwanis meeting. We're going to support them in their endeavors. I just found out Monday at a board meeting that the city owns Martin Theater. Am I correct?
Well, yeah.
Say that again.
The Martin Theater. Is it owned by the theater, the city? Yeah. You know, we're working on the outside with the clocks.
We are.
It's beautiful.
Yeah.
The Martin. And somebody told me that the inside was gutted. That theater has the best acoustics. And on a small level, you know, we can get with some of the youth groups in the neighborhood, being that it's owned by the city. We can go in there and we can have Friday night, whatever, comedy, jazz. Because on the side of the theater, it's being used. I can't believe that the inside is not being used. Just last
we're
week.
Working on
it. It's not done yet.
That's cool.
Yeah.
I don't know. I'm not questioning. And then, and also I was on a board meeting about the McKenzie House. You know, I think that's the interior that was voted on our agenda in the city meeting. But what are we going to do with the McKenzie House? You know, what type of city project? Is it going to be something for visitation? And when you're doing that, you can combine the Martin Theater with the McKenzie Park with the revitalization of downtown Marina, all in one project, like y'all was talking about on the roads. That's all I'm concerned about. Just something to put in your thinking. Thank you.
While Ms. Clay comes up to the podium, I wanted to share one more thing with regard to World Changers. So we're working very closely with World Changers. They have over 200 volunteers that have come to help the city of Panama City recover from the storm. They arrived yesterday. One of the projects that they have is to paint A.D. Harris, the exterior. So we'll be getting that painted, just so that you know. It will be pressure washed, sandblasted, and we are painting that facility.
Good morning, Michelle Clay, 3104 Justine Court. I just have three questions today. You mentioned, or you had a handout of the funding for the CRA. Is there a way for the public to get access to that, to view? Second, do we know when the grants will open again? And then there was a mention of a fencing grant to move from chained fences to something different. Is that a separate grant? And if so, when is that grant going to be available? Thank you.
Okay, so to answer your question about the grant, let's start there, the grant application cycle. So we're going to do some changes and revisions to the grant application cycle. And so we need to allow staff time in which to accomplish that. Once we've completed that, we hope to reopen probably August 1st. Is that a good deadline date? October 1st, I'm sorry, I said August. October 1st to get that completed. You asked about the Glenwood Community Center, is that was the other question that you asked?
No, the fencing. I heard somebody mention a fencing grant to change the chain fence to something different.
Okay. Part of the city's code is for there to be decorative fencing. So part of our revisions to our grant program is to include the fact that it has to be a decorative fence. So one idea of a decorative fence is considered a wrought iron fence, and perhaps a picket type fence and things along those lines. Chain link fences will no longer be available, especially if it fronts a major road.
All right. Thank you for being here today.